Hey guys, Harrison here, and the SNES Mini is really, really cool. After using it for a few weeks now, it's pretty easy to understand why it's been so hard to get a hold of one. In fact, I'd say its only downside is that it only comes with 21 games pre-installed on it, and there's no official way to add extra games to it. Luckily though, there is an unofficial way to add some extra games onto it, and that's what we're going to be looking at today. As a warning, before we get started, if you do make a mistake, there is a possibility that you could end up bricking your SNES Mini, so make sure you're following along closely. So the first thing we need to do is download Hackchi, which is the program that's going to allow us to add those extra games to our SNES. So just visit the link in the video description and download the zip file and then extract it. You're also going to need some SNES ROMs. You'll have to find those for yourself, and they can come as either a .zip or .smc file. Now we're going to start up the Hackchi program, select SNES from the menu, and now we can import the SNES ROMs that we want to add onto our SNES Mini. To do that, just press Add More Games and then choose the games that you want to add onto your SNES Mini. Hackchi will process them and then add them to the queue. Now you'll see at the bottom of Hackchi there's that little green bar that tells you how much space you've used up. Most SNES Minis have around 200 megabytes of free space, so make sure that you do not exceed that. Once you've imported all your ROMs, select them all and right click, and then press download box art to have Hackchi automatically download the box covers for each game. Now we're almost ready to upload the games to our SNES Mini. There's just one thing left. What we're going to do is dump the kernel from our SNES Mini. This means that if anything was to go wrong in the future, we can basically factory reset our SNES Mini. So to do that, we're going to go kernel, dump kernel. Select yes, and now we have to connect the SNES Mini into our PC. So just plug it in with the micro USB cable that it came with and make sure that it's turned off. Now we have to put our SNES Mini into a sort of recovery mode. So to do that, make sure that the power switch is turned off and then hold down the reset button on the SNES Mini, and while you're still holding it down, flick the power switch on. Keep holding the reset button down for a few seconds and you'll see that the power light does not come on, and that means that it's been put into recovery mode. Back on our computer now, just press install driver and Hackchi will install the driver that we need to talk to the SNES Mini. Then press enter and Hackchi will automatically start dumping the kernel. Now do not touch your SNES Mini while this is happening. Don't even breathe on it. Seriously, just keep your hands off the SNES Mini whenever this green loading bar is on the screen, because these are the times that you can end up bricking your SNES Mini. So give Hackchi a few seconds and it'll say that it's finished. Now I strongly suggest that you save this file that it's created somewhere, because if you do lose this file and something goes wrong with your SNES Mini, then you're in big trouble. So I just copied it to my Google Drive. Now we're almost ready to flash the games onto our SNES Mini. Make sure your SNES Mini is still in that recovery mode, and then go back to Hackchi and press that synchronize button. Because this is the first time that we're adding games to our SNES Mini, Hackchi will tell us that we need to flash the custom kernel. Just press yes and Hackchi will automatically flash the kernel to our SNES Mini. Once it's done, press OK, and then Hackchi will flash those games to our SNES Mini. And that's all there really is to it. If you unplug your SNES Mini from your computer and reconnect it to your TV or monitor and power it up, you should see that a new folder has been created on your SNES Mini. Open up the folder and inside you'll find all the games that you've added. So open one up and give it a try. You'll find that it plays exactly like the games that came pre-installed on our SNES Mini. They run perfectly and they even support the extra features like save states. And if you want to add some more games to your SNES Mini, it's even easier the second time around. Just reconnect your SNES Mini to your PC, make sure it's switched on, and then just add the extra games into Hackchi. Make sure to download the box art like I forgot to, and then press synchronize, don't touch anything, and there you go. That's all there really is to it though. So thanks for watching, I hope you found this video useful, and I'm gonna have more videos on the SNES Mini coming up in the future, including how to get Game Boy games on the SNES Mini. So if you want to see those, make sure to leave a like and subscribe down below. While you're there, it'd be awesome if you could let me know in the comment section some of your recommendations for SNES games that I should try out. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media, on Twitter and on Instagram. Apart from that though, thanks for watching, and I'll catch ya in the next video.